Guys, today's gonna be a really fun video. I actually didn't think this was gonna work at all, but I was wrong. It's already really entertaining in the studio today.
All right.
Woo! In today's video, we're gonna see what effect helium and sulfur hexafluoride have on musical instruments.
I think a lot of you have seen the effect of breathing in helium and then speaking. Your voice raises up to a strange chipmunk level. Some of you have also probably seen that you can do the reverse with sulfur hexafluoride, dropping your voice down to an unnatural register.
Thank you.
But today we want to try something a little bit different with these. Yes, it makes our voice change, but can we change instruments too?
Here's the basic idea. We're going to play several musical instruments with helium and sulfur hexafluoride to see how the sound changes.
So the tests are pretty straightforward. What we have is four different musical instruments. Well, with one of them, we're pushing the definition of musical instrument.
What is that exactly?
This is a hose that went between a foot pump and an exercise ball.
Okay.
But with the ridges that go all the way down through it, it makes the air vibrate and fluctuate as you go down. They actually sell these, like a larger version of these, as toys. You just sort of spin them, see if it'll work. There you go.
Music!
But it also works to blow through them, which is what we're going to do to control the airflow and using other chemicals. So we want to do basically the same thing with both helium and sulfur hexafluoride. And then to make things more fun, we have a few other instruments as well. We have a recorder, and I believe our very own Grace is planning to provide us with her rendition of Hot Cross Buns. I think Mozart wrote that in 1735. Then we also have with us, we have a saxophone player and a bagpipe player, so we can try it with those things as well. So,
and with one of those, we're actually going to try and see if we can pump some of the helium or the sulfur hexafluoride into the bagpipes themselves, and we'll see what happens.
All right, so I'm gonna try and see what the lowest note I can play on this is, and then maybe the highest note, and then I'm going to breathe in a lot of helium and do the same things. So here's just sort of a normal blowing speed. If I breathe less, let's see if I get lower. That's about as low as I can get. If you breathe pretty hard and fast.
I regret that immediately.
It's pretty potent and not in a kind, nice way. So I'm gonna see what happens differently if I first breathe in a lungful of helium, a whole breath of helium, and do the same tests. Pretty normal.
Can't make as much noise.
I can't do a low one at all.
How much harder are you breathing now?
Not much.
Okay.
Of course, the helium does displace oxygen, so as you do this, you can get lightheaded and you need to be very careful about that. One more thing I want to try, just the balloon directly.
Okay.
It's a loud and annoying noise.
Great.
That is pretty awful. So I'll do the same thing using the balloon and helium so I don't have to get as lightheaded.
This will be fascinating if it works.
Oh, wow.
Whoa!
That is a very
dog
high
whistle.
Pitch.
That was terrible.
That's about as high as I got when I was blowing full blast into it, and the balloon is definitely not putting out as much pressure.
All right.
Is something you want to try with it?
Nope, I want to see sulfur hexafluoride now.
Okay. It is approximately 6 times as dense as the air we breathe. And this manifests in some interesting ways. This balloon is relatively quite heavy. We've done some experiments where we put balloons of normal air in sulfur hexafluoride, and if you breathe it in,
it changes your voice to a much lower pitch.
Wow!
So that
That's
was way
bizarre.
Lower already. Like, I can't hit that note breathing through it normally. I like that I can play straight from the balloon into the instrument. That's nice. Fun other fact about sulfur hexafluoride, it is much less conductive, electrically conductive than air. Now, air is already a pretty good resistor, but sulfur hexafluoride is a much better resistor. It really does not like to let electricity pass through it. So it's used in electronics sometimes if you need places to prevent sparking.
This is an $80 sound.
Sulfur hexafluoride is also pretty expensive.
Give us your best hot cross buns on the recorder.
My elementary school teacher is gonna be so proud.
This is going great.
So not proud.
Let's go for helium. Have to take a nice deep breath and then try and play the exact same thing.
A couple more musicians?
I think, yeah.
Please get the professional
actual musicians,
because that is not me.
Let's bring in a saxophone.
Okay.
This is my friend Steven from Utah Live Bands, and he is here with his saxophone, which, as you may have just heard, he plays amazingly, but so far, you've pretty much exclusively played it with normal air breath, as I understand.
As long as this is all normal air.
This is,
well, it's maybe a little contaminated at this point, but for the most part. So you wanna give this thing a try with helium and see how that sounds?
Let's do it. Should we do a bass?
Let's do a low, maybe scale.
Okay.
Exact same thing.
Same stuff.
Every time.
Wow.
And every time he took a breath, it like went down a half step.
Yeah.
So it sounded like he was actually doing like scales, but it was the same notes every time. Well, he was trying to be this. It was the same keying, same fingers.
Yeah, that's a lesson for all you people learning the instrument. You don't have to learn all the keys. You just...
Helium, yeah. Learn it in one key, change with helium as appropriate. That is fantastic. All right.
Sounded amazing. I love how every time you take a breath in, it just bumps it up a little bit at a time until it all clears out. That's very entertaining to hear.
Mm-hmm. It's the coolest.
All right, I think we have one more instrument we're gonna go for.
Mm-hmm.
Callie, you have a friend who plays the bagpipe.
I do. In fact, my friend Laura, we work together at Evermore theme park, and she plays a character named Piper who plays the bagpipe. So let's go grab
her. All right. Thank you again, Steven from Utah Live Bands.
So the part you play the melody on is actually called a chanter. It's got a double reed, kind of like an oboe, and it can play by itself. This is the loud part. You can hear like a mile away. Yeah, and so you put that in. There's only 9 notes on the scale,
Inside each one of these is another reed. Looks like that. And they can also play by themselves.
That little part right there. That's what's making the buzzing.
Yeah, when the air goes under there, it makes that little plastic. So it's a lot, actually, it's a lot like a, it sounds like when you put a blade of grass between your fingers and you're making that blade of grass vibrate. This way, sorry. Sounds exactly like a blade of grass. And I'm gonna blow this bag up and
then you play it by squeezing with your arm. Very
awesome.
Cool.
Thanks.
Well, we've now had a wonderful sampling of that with normal air, and I think now we want to see if we can pull that off with our other gases.
I'm getting ready for this.
All right, that's pretty full. There's your balloon. Do what you can do. It didn't like to stay in any one key. I was just like, let's go to 6 different keys.
You know, I didn't know if it was possible to make the bagpipe sound more out of tune.
Oh boy,
but I think we just did it.
Beautiful.
How are you feeling? You like?
Oh yeah, no, this is normal for bagpipers.
It'll be interesting if you can notice that it's.
That's a ding.
Oh my God.
Well, there you go. That is a new low droning note for bagpipes.
That's amazing.
Wow.
That's fantastic. I think that is a wonderful. Proof of concept. This works so well, like better than I thought it would, and it's so entertaining to hear what the instruments hit.
It was great.
Thank you very much for
bringing
and playing the bagpipe so well for us.
You bet.
Thank you to Stephen for the saxophone, Grace for your amazing rendition of Hot Cross Buns on the recorder, and I, of course, will be doing a world tour of the...
Tickets are on sale now.
Yeah, it's, a couple stadiums are sold out, but everything else is still available. Helium and sulfur hexafluoride, very low density gas and very high density gas, played through musical instruments. So cool to hear them change the way they do. If there's anything else you'd like to see us try with these things, let us know and we might give it a shot.
Guys, that's not all. You know we've always got more for you to see. If you hit that box down at the bottom, you can subscribe so you never miss out on the fun. We'll see you in the next one. Talk to you then. Woo!